Hey everyone, as leaders we decided that we wanted to still keep doing some little club talks for you guys, even if we can't meet in person for club or campaigners like we normally would. But this is going to be the first week, and over the next few weeks you'll hear from different leaders just talking about a Bible story or a verse that has been helping them through this time, kind of contained at home. So I'm going to kick it off this week, and I wanted to share with you guys a story from the Old Testament. It's in the book of 1 Samuel, and I'll be in chapter 7 if you guys want to follow along. So in this story, there's a group of people called the Israelites, and these are the people that like most of the Old Testament is about, and they have a leader named Samuel at this time of the story, and these people find out that they are going to be attacked. So they hear word that there's another group of people that are going to come to attack them. So naturally they feel really scared and afraid. There's this like looming, overwhelming fear that surrounds them, and they say, starting in verse 7, it says, "When the Israelites heard of it, they were afraid." And then it says, They said to Samuel, "Do not stop crying out to the Lord our God for us, that he may rescue us from the hand of the Philistines." So you know, they're telling their leader Samuel, "Hey, keep praying for us. Keep asking God to protect us and to rescue us." And I think that's a really cool thing that they, their kind of gut reaction was to say, "Hey, we need God in this time. We need to rely on him for him to protect us and to be with us." So this battle happens, and they end up winning the battle. But after that, this is kind of my favorite part of the story. Samuel took a stone, and it says in verse 12, it says, "He took the stone and set it up between Mizpah and Shen. He named it Ebenezer, saying, 'Thus far has the Lord helped us.'" So he took like an actual stone and placed it right in the site of where the battle was, and says, "This is a marking point of a point in our lives that God has helped us through. And up until this point, he has been faithful to us." So when I first learned about this story, I was challenged to look back at my own life and think about the Ebenezer stones in my own life. So think about situations that felt hard, but I saw God work in it, or that I saw God help me get through, or think about friends that I know God has specifically placed in my life, or maybe organizations like Young Life that, you know, I've got to be a part of. So, you know, any kinds of things like that where you can just see that God, you know, specifically was there for you and helped you and provided for you what you needed. So I have always kind of thought back to this story whenever I feel like I'm going through something where I'm kind of doubting if God's really here, or doubting if God cares about what's going on in my life. I'm always reminded about this story and how he's always been there for me in the past. So why is that going to change now? He promises us that it's not going to change, and he will still be with us always, even through these weird and hard times that you know, this whole spring kind of feels like. So I just want to challenge you guys to maybe do the same thing. Maybe take some time this week to sit down and think about the moments in your lives where God has been there for you and helped you through something. And then write those down. Write those down as your Ebenezer stones. And just be encouraged that just like he's been there in the past, he's gonna keep being there for you guys in the future, especially during this season. So, you know, years from now, we're all gonna look back at this time, and it'll be one of our own Ebenezer stones. We'll say, you know, this was hard, but God helped us through it, and he taught me this during the time. And we're each gonna have our own unique story like that, and I'm really excited to just kind of see what you guys all learned through this experience. We're all praying for you guys as leaders, just praying that you're doing well at home, and we just want you to know that we miss you guys a lot, and we love you, and we'll see you soon. Bye.